हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बाय ज्ञान मिश्री मॉडर्न स्कूल। अवर सब्जेक्ट इज साइंस फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9th एंड अवर चैप्टर ऑनगोइंग चैप्टर इज चैप्टर नंबर 10 ग्रेविटेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर अप टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। व्हाट इट इज, देयर इज अ फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन एनी टू ऑब्जेक्ट इन द यूनिवर्स एंड दिस फोर्स इज directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, and the force is along the centers of two objects. Also students, we have derived the formula for it in the derivation, and it is F is equal to G mm upon d square, where this m is the mass of one object, this m is the mass of other object, and d is the distance between the centers of two objects in meter. And what is this g? G is universal constant of gravitational. Also we have derived the value of capital G, that is 6.673 into 10 raised to minus 11 newton and newton per meter square into newton meter per kg square or kg raised to minus 2. And this value was calculated by the Henry Cavendish, and all these things we have discussed in the previous video. Now, today's our topic is free fall. When any object, when thrown on the from the very high level or a top level, it will come on the earth. Why? Due to the gravitational force of the earth. Take out students, page number 134, free fall. We have learned that the earth attracts object towards it. This is due to the gravitational force of the earth. Whenever object falls towards the earth under this force alone, we say the object are in free fall. Means, what is the meaning of this only? Means, there is no any other force. Forces are acting on it, like wind, storm, or if there is no any other force, only one force is there, that is of only the gravitational force, then it is called free force. Otherwise, there can be the other forces which are acting on this object. Suppose very light object we are throwing, suppose a paper. So it will come on the earth in this way by moving slowly in the slow motion. Why this is so? Because wind is there and the density of this object is very less than. So it will move away. But gravitational force is acting from the lower side. So it will come on the earth, but it will take time. So these are other forces acting on it. And here also the friction is there. Now when the object comes on the earth, what happens students, when it will fall on the earth, the force will be acting on the that object. Now the question here is, this force is the same as the top level, at the middle level where it is very near to the earth. Suppose this is the earth and one object is coming on this earth due to the gravitational force of the earth. Now this force on the object will be same at this point, will be same at this point, will be same at this point or not. The question here is about this. The amount of gravitational force at the top level means so many kilometers away, it will be same as the 50 kilometers away when it is, and is it will be same as at 25 kilometers? The answer is no. There is a difference between the gravitational force acting on the object is same, but what here different? Distance between this and this object is different, and we know it is inversely proportional to the the square of the distance between them. We have learned this in the universal law of gravitation. So when the object is here, the gravitational force on that object will be less, but as it comes towards the earth, its velocity increases because gravitational force increases. At this point, its velocity is somewhat lesser than the velocity of the same object. On this level, it is somewhat more than at this level, because as the object is coming towards the earth, the more and more gravitational force is acting on it, and so the velocity changes. And why this is so? Because the change in the gravitational force, as the distance decreases, gravitational force increases. And when there is a change in velocity, and we know what is change in velocity, is acceleration. Acceleration means change in velocity. We have learned this in chapter number 8. What is acceleration means change in velocity. So here the velocity is different. When the object is coming, it will take few seconds, but only the velocity at this point is different. When it comes on this point or any other this point, its velocity will somewhat increase. So change in velocity, change in its speed, velocity. Why it is here we are using the word velocity? Because the direction is fixed and velocity is a vector quantity which requires a direction. So speed and direction, magnitudes are same, but the difference is of only the direction. So here the speed of this object or velocity of this object is gradually increasing as it comes towards the earth. And this is called change in velocity. And here we are getting this change in velocity is denoted by small g. And it is called acceleration. Due to gravity. Why this change in velocity is there when object is in free fall? So this change in velocity is due to the force of attraction of the earth, means gravitational force of the earth. And when there is a gravitational force of the earth, this change is due to gravitational force of the earth. Therefore, it is g, denoted by small g. This g is capital G. This is universal constant of gravitation. And this is a small g. It is acceleration due to gravity. So make difference between these two g's. First is capital G. Universal constant of gravitation, its value remains constant anywhere in the universe, and this g value will somewhat change because when it comes on the earth, gradually velocity increases. Therefore, value of g is minor difference is there, not big difference is there, but the difference is there, and therefore it is denoted by small g, acceleration due to gravity. So again, we will derive the formula for g. From the universal law of gravitation, we know F is equal to g m upon d square. Now, we know F is the force of attraction between two objects. These objects can be on the earth, or from these objects, one can be earth, one can be any objects, any two objects in the universe. Now, what is G? Universal constant of gravitation. M and M, M and M means here, M means the mass of one object, M, small m, is the mass of other object, D square, the square of the distance between two. Here, if we compare the earth and any object on the earth, so in comparison of this earth, mass of the this object is negligible, so it can't be considered. Now here, what is F? F is the force, and also we know F is equal to mg. We have learned this formula in the previous chapters. Force is equal to mass into gravitational force. So here we will substitute. Instead of F, we will write mg is equal to g m upon d square. Now we want the value of this g only. So m upon d square. This m goes on the denominator, mm will get cancelled, and we get g m upon d square. So this is the relation between universal constant of gravitation and gravitational force due to the gravity of the earth. So g is equal to g m upon d square. So this is the relation between this g and this g. Value of this g is 6.67 or 6.673 into 10 raised to minus 11. Value of g approximately equal to 9.8. Now students, this g, gravitational due to the acceleration due to gravity. So it is actually the acceleration. So unit of small g is equal to meter per second square. Because we know the unit of acceleration is meter per second square. So just note down this students, then we will see the difference between capital G and small g. Now, take out page number 135 from your textbook. How the value of small g can be calculated? It is given here, student. You no need of explaining or solving this sum. Just how it is solved, you have to see here. To calculate the value of small g, we should put the value of g, m and r in equation. Now here, if the object, big object is m, means earth, and the other object is any object, but in comparison with this earth, the mass of this object is negligible, so it is taken not considered here. Now g m upon m d square. What is d? D is the distance between this and this. Again, in comparison of radius of the earth, this is the radius of the earth. In comparison with radius of the earth, the distance between the object and earth is also negligible. So here it is taken as, instead of d square, it is taken as r square. And what is r? R is the radius of earth. Because this is very, very big distance, long distance, in comparison with this distance. Here I have drawn, it is looking both are similar, but actually in actual practice, this distance is very, very big. And the distance between the object and earth is negligible. So here it is considered as the distance between the object and the earth is just the r square, means the radius of the circle. Again, students, give attention here. Value of g is given 6.7 into 10 raised to minus 11 newton meter square per kg square. Mass of the earth 6 × 10⁻²⁴ kg, because it is mass. Students, you should know the units which are here, and radius of the earth. And R is equal to 6.4 × 10⁶ meter. So value, all these values are substituted in this formula, and value of G is calculated, and G is equal to getting 9.8 meter per second square. So no need of finding the calculating this value. Just remember approximately 9.8 meter per second square. But remember, student, this value of small g is not constant everywhere, just like the value of this capital G. Value of capital G is equal to 6.67 × 10⁻¹ⁱ is constant everywhere, but most probably the value of small g is 9.8, but it is not constant everywhere. Okay, so now our next point. How it differs from place to place, we can say. Now we can see our earth. Is not the perfectly round in shape. The shape of the earth is somewhat orange shape, bulging at the equator. Our earth not the perfect square. This is earth. Now this distance is less and this distance is more than this one, because earth is not perfectly the sphere. It is orange shape, so it is just like this. It is bulging at the equator from the side, and it is tapped from upper and lower part. Now suppose the object is here and object is here. When the object is at poles, these are the poles. This is the north pole and this is the south pole. This is the equator. When object is at north pole or south pole, the distance between E and that object, earth means center of the earth and that object, is somewhat less. Then if object is at equator, the distance between the center and equator is more. So as the center distance is more, force of attraction is less, because they are inversely proportional to each other. And when the object is this pole, the distance is less, therefore the force of attraction is more. So value of G is different from at pole and also at the equator. At the pole, there is a slight difference between the value of G at poles and at the equator, but the difference is there. So from this, we can say value of G is not constant every time or anywhere. Value of capital G is constant every time, everywhere. Value of small g is not constant everywhere. So students, here we can write the difference between the capital G and the small g. This is small g and g. So in the first point, we can write like this. it is defined as acceleration due to gravity, and it is defined as universal constant of gravitation. This is about the capital G. Now the second one. Second point, value G is equal to 9.8, value of G is equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. Third point, we can say for unit, it is acceleration, and we know the unit of acceleration, SI unit is meter per second square, and here the unit Newton meter square per kg square, or it can be written as Newton meter square kg raised to minus 2, because when kg comes in numerator, its power, sign of power decreases, changes. Its value changes from 2+. When it is at the equator, its value is less. When it's it is on the pole, its value is higher. It remains constant. Here also we can say value of G is more at poles than equator. This type of question can be asked in MCQs. So this is the difference between G and G. What is G? Is acceleration due to gravity. What is capital G? Is universal constant of gravitation. Okay students, so this is about the G and G, and today, now enough for today. We will time for homework. Just write the homework. Write and learn difference between small g and capital G. So this is homework for today. Okay, we will go further in the next period. Okay, bye, take care.
जाएगी।